Hello everyone and welcome back to The Perfect French with Dylan. Today we're gonna learn irregular verbs ending in ER. ER. The last 2 weeks we saw how to conjugate verb ending in ER, present tense. Then we saw 20 or 25 ER verb with sentences. Today we're gonna learn the irregular one. The only thing that you have to understand is that they are not from the second group. They are from the third group, but they are usually mistaken from the second group. So this is why I'm doing this video after the two other ones, even though they are from the third group. But the third group is only irregular verbs, so we are going to get to it anyways. All those verbs are in my new ebook right here, 500 most common French verbs, how to conjugate them and how to use them. If you want the free PDF version of it, I'm gonna put the link in the description box. It will come on Amazon with probably 20 pages of exercise this week or next week, and it will be for free as well for a few days. So if you want to get an email when it's getting for free on Amazon, go to my website and leave your email out there. Today is no exception. On my website, you can also get the free PDF of this lesson. I'm going to review very, very quickly pronouns subjects, even though we see them all the time, just in case you don't know them. Also, all the video I'm going to talk about in this video and the video about the pronoun subject and everything related to this video, to conjugation and everything I'm going to talk about are all going to be in the description box. So for the pronoun subject, we have je, tu, il, elle, on, nous, vous, il, elle. The first verb we are going to see today is partir, to leave. And it will be conjugated exactly the same way as dormir, to sleep, mentir, to lie, sentir, to feel or to smell, servir, to serve, and sortir, to go out. We are going to see only partir right now, but they are all conjugated the exact same way. So you remember that to find the radical, the part of the verb that is not going to change, we need to get rid of the ending, er. In this case, it's a bit different as je, tu, il, elle et on have a shorter radical. We are not going to use the T, the last letter of the radical, which is technically P-A-R-T, is not going to be used for the five first ones, for the singular ones. But we are going to use the radical for nous, vous, il, elle. So for plural is the normal radical, for the singular one is the shorter one. Then we have the ending, which is S, S, T, 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 O-N-S, E-Z, E-N-T, E-N-T. The endings are not that hard. And if you put them together, je pars, tu pars, il part, elle part, on part, nous partons, vous partez, ils partent, elles partent. So as usual, you can see that the five first one, or the singular one, are pronounced exactly the same. We don't pronounce the S at the end, we don't pronounce the T at the end. So it's just part for all of them. And if we see it in a sentence, est-ce que nous partons bientôt? Est-ce que nous partons bientôt? Are we leaving soon? So you remember that this verb is conjugated exactly the same as all these ones. If you want to practice, if you want to make sure that you got it right, you can conjugate any of them, of course, not partir, but conjugate it in the comment section and I will make sure that you got it right. The second type of verb we are going to conjugate today is offrir, offrir, to offer. Then ouvrir, to open, couvrir, to cover, and cueillir, to pick. So all the endings that are L-L-I-R, so do you remember that we don't say cueillir, we say cueillir. It's like a long E. We don't pronounce the double L. All the ending that's like V-R-I-R and F-R-I-R. They're all in my book. They're really, really well explained in my book. If you want to just grab it, it's also very good to review. So today we are going only to see offrir. Offrir, to offer. This one is actually quite simple because the radical is going to stay the same. So radical is OFFR. We don't use ER, of course. And then we are going to add the ending, which is exactly the same as the conjugation of the first group of verb ending in ER. So it makes it quite easy. Only present tense, you remember that, right? So the ending are E, ES, E, 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 ONS, EZ, ENT, ENT. It's really the same. You can go check out my video about verb ending in ER, it's exactly the same. So if we put them together, we have j'offre, tu offres, il offre, elle offre, on offre, link, nous offrons, link again, vous offrez, link, ils offrent, elles offrent. So the only one that we pronounce differently are offrons, offrez, all the other ones are pronounced exactly the same, offre. And in a sentence, j'offre un cadeau à mon frère. J'offre un cadeau à mon frère. So do you remember that all those verbs are conjugated exactly the same way? So if you want to practice, pick one of them, not offrir, and conjugate it in the comment section and I will correct you. The third and fourth one we are going to see today, it's the same kind of verb, but I'm going to conjugate them both because we use them all the time and they are very, very irregular. The first one is venir, to come. The second one is tenir, to hold. So you can see only the first letter change, so it's going to make it easy for that, but the ending is actually very irregular and very confusing. So let's see the first one, venir. In this case, the radical is technically only going to be V, V. The ending, E-N-I-R, is going to change. So if we put the radical V everywhere, and then the ending is IEN, I-E-N-S, IEN, I-E-N-S, IEN, I-E-N-T, 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 then we have E-NOM, E-N, ONS, ENE, ENEZ, and YEN, YEN, IENNENT. And then the same, IENNENT. Told you they're really irregular. So if we put them together, we have je viens, tu viens, il vient, elle vient, on vient. So they're all pronounced the same again. Nous venons, venons. So we pronounce the E like a E. Nous venons. Vous venez. Ils viennent. So in this case, it's like a E. Viennent. Elles viennent. And in a sentence, il vient avec nous ce soir. Il vient avec nous ce soir. So if we see tenir now, to hold, it's exactly going to be the same thing. The T is the only thing that's going to stay as a radical. So we put them here, and then we have the ending, which is exactly the same. IEN, 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 IEN. ENON, ENE, IEN, IEN. It's exactly the same as venir. And if we put them together, je tiens, tu tiens, il tient, elle tient, on tient, nous tenons, vous tenez, ils tiennent, elles tiennent. And in a sentence, il tient la main de sa mère. Il tient la main de sa mère. So if you want to practice, don't forget to leave me a comment. If you have a question about French, about me, about literally anything, you can just leave me a comment. I would be more than happy to answer. You can also connect with me on my Instagram, my Facebook page, and this YouTube channel, of course. And I will see you soon for another lesson.